Hello everyone, you are watching sqadia.com and I am Dr. Hamad Haider. Today our topic is scoliosis. So what is scoliosis? It's actually the abnormal bending of the spine. And as you know, that's actually in form of a 3D problem. We'll be discussing the scoliosis in detail. We'll be mainly discussing what are the different classification systems for the scoliosis and how it has actually been classified. Then we'll be moving on towards what is the difference between a postural scoliosis and structural scoliosis. What exactly we need to look at for when we're dealing with the postural scoliosis and the problems with the hip, or whether it is a structural problem of the spine. Then we will be moving on towards the brief clinical features, what we need to know on history, and what we need to examine on the physical examination. What we need to look for, especially when we have to assess the patient from the back, from the front, as well as from the side. And when we need, what often once we have taken the history and examination, how do we classify the type of scoliosis our patient has, whether it's early onset or late onset, whether it's juvenile or congenital or adolescent idiopathic, whether it's postural or whether it's structural. And with any disease, once you've taken the history and examination, you go for some form of a radiological as well as biochemical workup. We will be discussing in detail how to get the x-rays, how to get the compensatory views or lateral and forward bending views, and how to calculate the Cobb angle. And once we calculate the Cobb angle, what are the different indications for getting a CT or a MRI as well. From then, we are moving on to the special tests which may be associated with the scoliosis. Especially, we'll be discussing briefly the cardiopulmonary function tests and why they are important. From then onwards, we'll be discussing the different patterns of scoliosis. It could be in form of congenital scoliosis, it could be juvenile scoliosis, or it could be adolescent idiopathic scoliosis. Or it could be involving in terms of the curves, whether it's lumbar or thoracolumbar scoliosis only. Then from then onwards, we will be discussing briefly the in details what is the late onset scoliosis and what is the early onset scoliosis, and how to deal with these form of scoliosis actually, and what are the different criteria, whether we go for surgery or whether we go for some form of bracing or we just observe. From then onwards, we will be specially discussing early onset juvenile idiopathic scoliosis and what are the indications to go for some form of bracing or surgery. We will be briefly discussing the congenital scoliosis as well, and we'll be also discussing the different type of congenital malformations which can happen in the vertebra, which can eventually lead to an aggressive form of scoliosis. From then, we'll be briefly discussing the scoliosis which may be syndromic or associated with the neuromuscular diseases, especially the neuromuscular scoliosis which is actually more aggressive, there are more rigid curves, and actually slightly relatively difficult to treat. We'll be briefly discussing how to manage surgically the neurofibromatosis or scoliosis which is associated with neuromuscular disorders. To watch more videos, you go to www.sqadia.com and you can watch all the orthopedic related videos as well, related to spine as well as you can go there and watch all other videos related to different aspects of medical sciences, right from basic sciences up till the clinical as well as the those which is specially associated with the paraclinical pathology associated videos as well. Thank you very much. Keep watching sqadia.com.